Elle est à toi, cette chanson. Toi, l'Auvergnat qui, sans façon, m'a donné quatre bouts de bois quand dans ma vie il faisait froid. Toi qui m'a donné du feu quand.
And part of being an artist, you know, it's never being satisfied with how you define yourself, because, you know, at some point you're done, right? And you're done with what you're doing, and it's time to step back and say, well this isn't me anymore, and then you have to move on.
I guess that's true. Like,
I mean, look, it took me years. You know, I was taking my BFA, and then when someone asked me, well, what are you doing? I'd say, well, I'm getting my degree, you know? And they would ask me, well, how many years have you got left? And, well, I'd just say, well,
yeah, exactly.
So, you know, too many to really worry about, right?
Yeah, well, exactly.
And you know, I've had a gut-wrenching spiritual experience, but I mean, this still resonates inside my mind, and it never leaves, because it's part of the, you know, the schizophrenia. But they were what got me through, and this is in the pre-diagnosis days, but I knew that, you know, at my core, that I was a good person, and now I've got all that behind me, right? Alive, and
that's important, because a lot of people I know, they never get through that sort of stuff. I mean, it's really great to see you, you know, especially. So what are you working on now?
Well, you know, it's sort of complex, but I've been drawing on, you know, the 2 years I spent with my bees in British Columbia.
Oh, yeah, the bees.
Yeah, yeah, you know, that was the one time, you know, in my life. It's, you know, like a spiritual time for me. I really felt a connection until all that ended, and, you know, I wound up in the hospital again, and now, right, you know, 5 years later, I've kind of come back to that, you know.
Oh, really?
The diagnosis, yeah.
Full circle.
Well, you know, it's like, well, Joe, how can we incorporate that bigger picture, that experience, into the bigger picture of who I am, you know, as an artist,
the artist's life.
Well,
yeah. No, I see it. So, have you started painting bees, or
no,
you know, painting them anymore?
No. Yes, but I mean, at first I tried painting the bees, you know, the beauty, the organization, the harmony. But
yeah,
I found it difficult to really get across, you know, what I was trying to say, and because people are so cynical, you know, by nature, and they only see it as a reflection of themselves.
They always see themselves.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And you know, a negative thing, though, you know, like a whole kind of automaton kind of mindless.
Yeah,
exactly. It's pointless kind of thing, and that's not what I was trying to do. You know, that's not how I feel about my bees.
No, I mean, of course not.
But, you know, I realized that in order to understand the bees, you need to see them, you need to experience them, have them, you know, as a part of the art, you know. So I called in some favors, and I'm bending a few bylaws and whatnot. I bought myself a hive, and I moved it into the studio, you know, with me.
Oh, here downtown. Okay, so, the bees, into my studio, you say. And no, I never noticed when you did this. I'm actually kind of surprised.
Yeah. No, it's beautiful, though, you know. It's like I've blown the whole concept of art, like, wide open, and I'm really doing it now, you know? I mean, I'm not just stretching the envelope anymore. I mean, Brent, there is no fucking envelope. I'm free. I blew that fucking envelope to, you know, to smithereens. There are no limits now. And I think that's what people need to see. There's no limits to art.
Yeah, right. Yeah, cool. Hey, so how many bees did you move into my studio, hey? like a handful? You know, how many does it take to get that kind of feeling? Like,
no, not that many, really. A few hundred, maybe 500 really well-behaved, beautiful, serene bees. And they do exactly what I tell them. I mean, I've become one of their hive, Brent. I mean, I'm the fulcrum of their vast collective hive mind. You should see it, Brent. I mean, you should see what I've done with my bees. I could show you right now. I mean, just give me a few minutes to set up. I've made incredible progress. You know?
Yeah,
it's pretty great.
Don't they? I mean, I've seen a few shows. I mean, don't they ever sting you?
Well, isn't that a problem? Well, yeah, of course they do all the time. It's part of how we communicate. You know, it's how they tell me their limits, where they're willing to go.
Right. How often do they sting you?
No, I don't know, lots, I guess, but it's always difficult at the beginning, you know. Maybe I'm trying to get them to do something new, like carrying paint. The other day I was trying to get them to carry paint on their tiny little fuzzy little coats, you know, to be a...
Like little airborne paintbrush.
Well, I want them to be a direct participant, you know, in the painting process, you know, and they didn't respond well to it, and they sent me a message, and yes, I got stung, you know, maybe a dozen, maybe a few dozen times, you know, whatever. and of course, you know, I had to define my limits at that point, you know, and I took my palette, and I just started smashing them, you know,
sure.
just crushing them. It wasn't in anger, though, it was just in communication, you know, they're talking to me, you know, that's how they talk. It's like, hey man, hey Joe, this isn't cool, and I'm just like, you can't sting me, and never stop stinging me. That's not a workable relationship to be having with, you know, with someone. And now I think that we both understand. We've negotiated our terms. And I've stopped using oil paints and started using watercolors. You know, and that's not what I wanted. It's not exactly, you know, what I wanted, but. I compromised, and they've stopped stinging me so far, mostly. You know, we're making, you know, progress.
Yeah, but Joe, is this safe, Joe? I mean, it's obviously not safe for you, but
is it even safe? I mean, couldn't the bees escape into the building, into my building?
Oh God, Brent. Come on, that'll never happen. Never happen.
Okay, that's good, but I mean, that's what this is about, right?
Well, you see, Brent, the bees and I, we've got an understanding.
All right. Public, en se foutant pas mal du regard oblique des passants honnêtes, les amoureux qui se bécotent sur les bancs publics, bancs publics, bancs publics, en se disant des je t'aime pathétiques, ont des petites gueules bien sympathiques.